Stop.
Good morning, all of you. Today's session is for class 7 and the topic present in the colligative property. It is belonging to the synopsis 5. It is present in the page number C29. After the discussion of colligative properties, now coming to the one of its application, determination of molar masses. To determine the molar masses, we will follow the various methods. Among that, the first one is Ostwald dynamic method. Ostwald dynamic method. Now the relative lowering of vapor pressure, P naught minus P by P naught equal to chi S. Nothing but here number of moles of solute by total number of moles. For a dilute solution, number of moles of solute is very less than that of number of moles of solvent. Then we can write here A W represents weight of solute, W by M into capital W by capital E. Now small W represents here weight of solute, small m represents molecular mass of solute, capital W weight of solvent, capital M molecular weight of solvent. From this one we can write here M equal to W M into P naught by capital W into P naught minus P. By that equation, we can able to calculate the molecular mass of non-volatile solute. Now, coming to second method, that is the Rast method. In that Rast method, depression of freezing point is directly proportional to molality. Small m represents molality. Now, delta Tf equal to Kf into M. Now, from this one, delta Tf equal to Kf into weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of solvent in grams. From this one, molecular weight of solute equal to Kf into W into 1000 by capital W into delta Tf. Nothing but by this equation, we can able to calculate the molecular mass of the unknown solute. Ostwald dynamic method, Rast method. Now coming to third one, that is Cartel method. Elevation of boiling point is directly proportional to molality. While eliminating mol proportionality, delta Tb equal to Kb into M. Now here molality is given as weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of solvent in tons of grams. From this one, molality equal to ebullioscopic constant into W weight of solute into 1000 by delta Tb into capital W weight of solvent in grams. Now coming to fourth one, that is Barclay-Hartley method. Barclay-Hartley's method. The two scientists combinedly proposed the calculation of molecular mass of non-volatile solute in the given solution. That is with respect to the osmotic pressure. Pi V equal to N S T. Now for this one, pi v equal to weight by gram molecular weight and s equal to inverse of gas function, that is rt. From this one, m equal to w rt by pi into v. Now the last application also, calculation of molecular mass of a non-volatile solute in a given dilute solution. Now coming to the abnormal molar masses. Nothing but here, to calculate the molar masses and to correct the molar masses, now the solution should obey the following properties. What are the two properties? Nothing but solution should not be highly concentrated. Solution should not be highly concentrated. Now the solute molecules in a solution, it won't associate, nothing but neither association nor dissociation, of solute particles in a given solution, that is dilute solution. Now coming to association represents here number of smaller particles may combine each other to form a giant molecule with a huge mass. A giant molecule with huge mass. Nothing but here the molecules that can have less molar masses. Now less molar masses are combining to form a large molar masses. Now in the same way, dissociation is given by a simple molecule may divide into simple particles. Nothing but here it can have large or more molar mass. Now it may have here less molar mass. Now coming to van der Waals factor is given as the representation of I, and now that I equal to observed colligative properties by normal colligative properties. In the same way, it can also be written as normal molar masses divided by observed molar masses. Now here the comparison between observed should be in numerator with respect to colligative properties, observed should be in denominator with respect to their molar masses. Then how can we calculate the van der factor for the degree of dissociation? The equation is given as An gives us to n moles of A. Initial number of moles here 1. Before the occurring of reaction, the number of moles are here 0. Then if alpha is the degree of dissociation, alpha into n alpha initially 0, 0 plus n alpha, then it will make it the n alpha. Now initially 1, alpha is the degree of dissociation. Then number of moles at equilibrium condition are at a final 1 minus alpha. The total number of moles available 1 plus 0, 1. Now here 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. Now number of moles after dissociation 1 minus alpha plus n alpha, initial number of moles 1. Then we can take the ratio degree of dissociation alpha equal to number of moles dissociated by total number of moles, n total. Therefore 1 minus alpha plus n alpha divided by 1. Now what is the factor here? Van der factor, and it is represented by the symbol I. Initial, now here final equilibrium condition. Then finally we can write alpha equal to I, by simplifying the above equation, I minus 1 by n minus 1. Alpha value. Similarly, for degree of association, the equation can be written as n moles of A may combine to form a joint molecule, that is An. Initial number of moles here 1 and here 0. Now alpha is the degree of dissociation. To get the equilibrium constant here, alpha by n. Now here 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha. Then total number of moles 1 minus alpha plus alpha by n. Now total number of moles after association by initial number of moles, it is given by the Van der factor, that is 1 minus alpha plus alpha by n divided by total number of moles 1. From this one, alpha equal to I minus 1 by 1 by n minus 1, that is getting from the above equation. Now while taking NaCl, the number of moles, nothing but 1 mole of NaCl will divide into 1 sodium ion, 2 chlorine ion, 1 plus n, 1 plus 1, 2, nothing but n value represents here 2, number of moles after dissociation. Similarly, while taking MgCl to 1 magnesium ion, 2 chloride ions, 1 plus 2, 3, therefore total number of moles available, 3. In the same way, while taking aluminium sulfate, Al2, SO4, taken thrice, nothing but here 2 aluminium ions, 3 sulfate ions, 2 plus 3 will get the value 5. Okay, all these are the ionic compounds that behaves as a good electrolytes. Now in this session we discuss the determination of molar masses, one of the application of colligative property by using the various methods: Ostwald dynamic method, Rost method, Cartan's method, Buckley's method. Now applications of Van der factor. The applications of Van der factor, finally it is given by delta P naught minus P by P naught equal to I into chi x, one of the application. Another application in terms of depression of freezing point, delta Tf equal to I into Kf into M, delta Tb equal to I into Kb into M. Now pi equal to I into Cst. C represents concentration, S represents gas constant, T temperature in terms of Kelvin. All these are the applications of Van der factor. Thanks for watching.